Thanks for coming to the opening talk today. I hope you guys are well rested, ready for the day ahead, and to help set us up and set the tone for today, we have our first speaker, Anu. Anu co-leads the Indian Network for Impact, an EA community network in India. She's been running community building activities in India since 2021 and is the lead organizer of this conference along with their wonderful team. Anu studied literature at Durham University, her bachelor's, and is currently a master's student in India. For the first talk of the day, please welcome Anu.
We started working on looking into the possibility of organizing this first year conference in India about as far back as March 2022. And we eventually decided to host it in Jaipur, given its culture and heritage compared to big capital universities. But you might hear some trumpets in the background now and then because it's the wedding season in India, and Jaipur is a big destination where they come. Today is also the Kite Flying Festival, Makar Sankranti. So there is pongal for lunch, which is a special vegetable occasion. Before I go ahead, I would like to show this clip.
Strangers from distant lands, friends of old, have been summoned here to answer the threat of Mon. Middle Earth stands upon the brink of destruction. None can escape. Bring forth the ring. The ring was made in the fires of Mount Doom. Only there can it be unmade. It must be taken deep into Mordor and cast back into the fiery chasm from whence it came. One of you must do this.
Have you heard nothing Lord Edward has said? The ring must be destroyed.
I suppose you think you're the one to do it.
And if we fail, what then? What happens when Sauron takes back what is his?
I will be dead before I see the ring in the hands of an elf.
Let me come.
So much for the ring.
Rather than letting it become a group siding with any sort of philosophical, culture, or political ideology. It's the death of a movement when you become foot soldiers of an ideology and stop thinking critically, newly, as we are always facing new challenges, and the solutions to those new challenges must also be inspired from the historical. History and knowledge from different parts of the world can be harnessed when needed, but new thought also needs to be put in. No new, effective solutions that the big problems EA has its eyes set on can be solved without reflecting on the uncomfortable questions that will inevitably bring up uncomfortable truths and uncertainties. Within its aim to be honest, transparent, comfortable with the uncertain, EA's spaces need to remain beautifully weird, creating a space comfortable with discussions, open to new ideas, is the prerequisite to allow the birth and emergence of original groundbreaking ideas. It should be possible to debate the scientific temperament without degenerating into fallacy-induced arguments or letting any one particular view or model speak up. EA dared to pick up and rethink stagnant, long-term solutions to instead offer other ways of doing the same job more efficiently, cost-effective, and a measured manner. Anti-dogmatic is how EA has been, how it has evolved, and how it should keep being. To me, this is what makes it different from other social movements and leading philosophies. EA is many things: a philosophy, a research field, an ecosystem of organizations, a movement, and a community. As a philosophy that aims to discover how to really do good better, it has strong foundations of being very open with questioning and comfortably invites new ways of thinking, poses big questions that we don't ask ourselves, because there might be set ways of doing good. Today, the first EAGxIndia kicks off officially. In this first conference, it is very timely to think about what India and EA could exchange thoughts on, and where existing ideas have something to add to the richness of the other. Furthermore, developing more localized knowledge goes hand in hand with this. There are significant problems in India which potentially affect a large chunk of the global population itself, since we are a big country. I'd be very happy if people joining us here today someday look into the impact of addressing big neglected problems, such as air pollution, lack of hygiene, nourishment, and basic education, that we can help find a solution to this.
Yes, okay,
India holds immense opportunity for innovation and growth here, as not only does it have a higher and younger population, but it's a country that's constantly evolving, and thus is a great place for EA to flourish, which thrives in global experimentation. This conference is a good time to ask yourself what some areas of innovation might be. I think knowledge sharing and coordination can be an effective tool. One thing I appreciate about EA and have hopes for is the knowledge sharing component. Knowledge sharing benefits the society generally. A thread that should run consistently in all EA spaces is intellectual humility. To me, intellectual humility is about understanding that there is space to grow and be curious. Julia Gallup, a renowned author and podcaster from the rationality space, in her popular TED Talk asks the audience, what do you most yearn for? Do you yearn to defend your own beliefs? Or do you yearn to see the world as clearly as you possibly can? The aim of this conference is to come together as a community and think, listen, and talk freely. Be ambitious, challenge your own assumptions, and take ownership. In the next 2 days, a broad range of conversations, topics, will be covered by experts. Topics like global health, animal welfare, environmental issues, biosecurity, AI safety, community building and more. There's a potential, a gap, that AI can fulfill just by practicing and encouraging its epistemic space style of thinking. And this first conference is all about exploring that. Now I would like you all to spend some time thinking about these five questions for the next 10 minutes. So I'll put about 1 to 2 minute timer for each. Please take a minute to write down your answers. The first question is, what do you most appreciate about you? What parts inspire you to come home today? You all have some answers there. There's another. Moving on to the third question. What is the big problem you would like to solve? And what are steps you think you might take in the direction to equip yourself to do it? As a learner, what are some types of resources you wish you knew how to navigate? And as an expert, what are things you wish more people knew about or discussed? Moving on to the last question. What do you think you might be wrong about? That was all the questions. You can use the answers or questions you've come up with this exercise in your one-on-ones or throughout the conference if you wish. Feel free to use the boards outside. There are pens and sticky notes with these prompts, and if you wish to write something, you can. But have a great conference. See you all around. Thank you.